क्रिटिकल स्पीड ऑफ द बॉल मीन सर्व एज अ गाइडलाइन हाउ फास्ट द बॉल मिल शुड बी ऑपरेटेड. वी आर अवेयर दैट इन अ बॉल मिल ड्यू टू द रोटेशन ऑफ द बॉल मिल द बॉल्स आर लिफ्टेड अप व्हेन दे रीचेस टू द हायर इलेवेशन दे फॉल्स डाउन एंड देर इज अ इम्पैक्ट ऑफ द बॉल विद द मटेरियल एंड ड्यू टू इम्पैक्ट द साइज रिडक्शन अकर्स. बट फॉर द faster size reduction there should be more impact and the number of impacts depend upon the speed at which the ball mill is operated. However, even though more speed of the ball mill means more number of impact, we cannot increase the speed of the ball mill infinitely. We can increase the ball mill up to 50 to 70% of the critical speed for getting the satisfactory size reduction. Now, what is critical speed of the ball mill? Let us try to understand it. First of all, I'll define it and then we'll try to understand what is critical speed of the ball mill. So, I'm going to just state the classical definition of critical speed. Thereafter, we'll try to understand exactly what it is. So, it is the speed of the ball mill at which centrifuging occurs. It is the speed of the ball mill at which the centrifuging occurs. It is the speed at which the grinding medium does not lose the contact with inner wall of ball mill. Due to this, ball does not fall down . So there is no impact as a result, no size reduction. The ball just get carried around without impact. Therefore, power supplied is wasted. Now, why this happens? You are aware that when the ball mill is rotated, say this is the center of the ball mill, say this is the grinding medium, and there are some strips which are welded just to prevent rolling down of the ball when it is rotated. So whenever the ball mill is set into the rotation, this ball is lifted up and it may fall down, or it falls down and strike with the material, or because of the impact the size reduction occurs. Now on this ball there are two forces acting. One there are two forces acting, one towards the center and another away from the center. Now the force which acts towards the center is the component of gravity force, and the one which away from the center, also known as centrifugal force. So when the ball falls down, it means that at certain point of time the magnitude of the gravity force exceeds the magnitude of the force which is acting away from the center. See, because of gravity force, the ball falls down, or ball has a tendency to move downwards due to gravity force. However, there is a force which tries to push it away from the center, and that is centrifugal force. So the ball will fall down as long as, or from a point where the component of the gravity force has the value greater than the centrifugal force. But you are aware that centrifugal force is depends upon the speed mr omega square, where m is mass, r is radius, and w is angular velocity. So if you increase the speed, rotational speed, the centrifugal force increases. However, the mass of the ball is constant, so the gravity force is constant. However, the centrifugal force magnitude, even though ball is fixed, even though radius is fixed, but if angular velocity, that is speed, rotational speed is changed, the centrifugal force magnitude increases. So at one point of time, if you keep on increasing the speed, a stage will be reached at which the magnitude of the centrifugal force will be greater than or equal to magnitude of the gravity force, or the component of the gravity force. So component of the gravity force acts in the downward direction, and the centrifugal force acts in the upward direction. So whenever the magnitude of the centrifugal force is greater than or equal to magnitude of the gravity force, the ball does not fall down, it simply gets carried around. And if it gets carried around, and if it does not fall, then there will not be any impact. If there is no impact, there will not be any size reduction. And if there is no size reduction, whatever the energy is supplied, that energy is wasted. Already the crushing or the size reduction is most energy inefficient operation. The energy, generally the energy of size reduction equipment is somewhere around 0.1%. That means 99.9% of the power is wasted. And so since the power available actually for a size reduction is very less, and in that circumstances, if you operate the ball mill at a speed greater than critical speed, you will be losing the money, because whatever the energy supplied, whatever the energy is supplied, that is wasted. That is wasted. It is not utilized for the size reduction purpose. So that's why the ball mill should always be operated at a speed less than critical speed. Generally, it is recommended to operate it at a speed between 50 to 70% of the critical speed. That is operational speed of the ball mill. If I have to write, then I may say that the operational speed of ball mill is equal to 50 to 70% of critical speed. Operational speed of the ball mill is equal to 50 to 70% of the critical speed. What does it mean? So if the critical speed is 100, then ball mill will be operated between 50 to 70 RPM. So that is the significance of the critical speed. Now, there is one formula which relates the radius of ball mill, the radius of grinding medium, with the critical speed. So by substituting the value of radius of ball mill and radius of grinding medium, we can find out the critical speed. And if we maintain the speed of operational speed of our ball mill between 50 to 70%, we'll be able to obtain the desired performance of the ball mill. Now let us try to derive an expression for critical speed of the ball mill. So consider a ball mill. I am considering the cross-sectional view of the ball mill. So let R is the radius of ball mill. Small r is the radius of grinding medium, and we'll draw the line joining center of grinding medium with center of ball mill. Also draw a vertical line like this. Let the center is of ball is denoted with the center of ball is denoted with A. Center of ball mill is say denoted with O, and this one say denote it with B. The weight of the ball acts through the center of the ball in the downward direction. So it is mg. When the ball mill is set into a rotation, and when the ball is lifted up, then there is certain force, centrifugal force, which acts on the ball. And for the sake of distinction, I will use different colors. So this centrifugal force acts away from the center of the ball. Say it is denoted as FCF. Now, the weight of the ball acts through the center in a downward direction. However, to find out an expression for critical speed of the ball mill, we have to take force balance. And therefore, for taking the force balance, we have to resolve this. We have to resolve this along this particular line, AO. We have to resolve this particular force MG along this line, right? So let angle ABO, AOB is theta. So the angle made by AO and the point or the line along which this MG is acting in a downward direction means this angle, this will also be theta, because this particular line and this are like a parallel line, and this AO is an intersecting line. And these two say for the sake of your understanding, say if this arrowhead is represented as A dash. So this A dash AO angle and AOB angle both are same, because these are alternate angle and alternate angles are congruent. So let us start writing the derivation or the description related to derivation. So consider a ball mill of radius R. Let the radius of ball is equal to small r. Now radius of ball means radius of grinding medium. Now angle EOB is equal to theta. This angle AOB is angle made by line joining center of ball with center of ball mill angle AOB is an angle made by line joining center of ball with center of ball mill and length and line OB. End line OB. Now, the weight of the grinding medium or weight of the ball MG acts in downward x in downward direction. Say along line e dash. Let weight of the ball mg acts in downward direction. Say along line AA, angle AOB is theta. R is the radius of ball mill. Small r is the radius of grinding medium. And angle AOB theta. What is the angle AOB? It is the angle made by the line joining center of ball with center of ball mill and the line OB. Now, when this ball mill is set into the rotation, then because of the rotational motion, there are two forces which acts on the ball. And these two forces are the common force which acts on any object which is performing circular motion. And these two forces are centripetal force and centrifugal force. Now, the centrifugal force is the force which acts from the center but away from the center. This is FCF. Now, you are aware that the general formula of any centrifugal force is mv square by r. If it is related to rotational motion, then we say that it is equal to mr omega square, where m refers to mass, r refers to radius of circular path, and omega refers to angular velocity. Now, the radius of, suppose, if you just draw a locus of the path traced by the center of the ball, if you draw the locus of the path traced by the center of the ball, then this AO is the radius of circular path. And please remember, radius of ball mill is r. Now, this radius of ball, if you subtract this particular portion r from the radius of the ball mill, then the length AO, this particular thing, will be equal to capital R minus small r. So, the centrifugal force will be mv square upon capital R minus r. Again, when we are trying to take the force balance, then the condition is that the force must act on the same line. Now, here the gravity force is acting in a downward direction, and for the sake of calculating the net force, we must take the component of the gravity force which acts along the line AO, and that component of the gravity force is mg cos alpha, because alternate angles, see, if this angle is theta, then this angle is also theta, and if you resolve along the line, then resolution along is f cos theta. F is mg, so mg cos theta. Let us write the steps in a detail, then we will do force balance, and then finally we'll simplify the equations to calculate the derivation or the an expression for critical speed of ball mill. From the figure we can write radius of circular path is equal to capital R minus R, where capital R is the speed, radius of the ball mill, and small r is the radius of ball. Say this is one. Second, magnitude of centrifugal force acting on ball. Magnitude of the centrifugal force acting on the ball is equal to m v square upon r minus r. Say this is equation 2. But whenever we consider the circular motion, this linear velocity v shall be expressed in terms of angular velocity. Therefore, we know that v is equal to r omega. R means radius. First of all, I will write the relation in a word. Linear velocity is equal to radius multiplied by angular velocity. And therefore, v is equal to r minus r into omega, where v is linear velocity in meter per second, omega is angular velocity in radian per second. Say this is equation number 3. V is equal to r minus r into omega. So if you substitute 3 into 2, so substitute 3 in 2, or by substituting 3 in 2, we get, so FCF, magnitude of the centrifugal force, is equal to m into r minus r into omega bracket square. See, I have replaced this v by this particular term. V is equal to r minus r into omega. Why r minus r? Radius of circular path. What is omega? Angular velocity divided by r minus r. So we can simplify. When r minus r will get cancelled, and after simplification we can write the final form of the centrifugal force. Therefore, after simplification, I can write centrifugal force is equal to m into 1, r minus r will get cancelled. So m r minus r into omega square. 1 r minus r was in the denominator, so it has cancelled 1, and therefore final expression is FCF into m into r minus r into omega square. This is equation number 4. Now, if you just try to recall the figure, then I told you that for resolution of the force, or for comparing, for finding out the net force and for resolution, for taking the force balance, both the force must act on the same line. And therefore, component of gravity force acting along the line joining center of ball and ball mill and opposite in direction to centrifugal force. Opposite in direction to centrifugal force. So, component of gravity force acting along the line joining center of ball and ball mill and opposite in a direction to centrifugal force can be written as Fg is equal to mg cos theta. Now, for the sake of understanding, we shall write that angle A dash A O and angle AOB is equal to theta, and the justification is alternate angle are congruent. Now, as per the concept of critical speed, or condition at which centrifugal and centripetal force. Now, centripetal force means component of gravity force. Please remember this force. As per the concept of critical speed or the condition at which centrifugal and centripetal force balance, the condition at which centripetal and centrifugal force balance, FCF is equal to FG. This is obtained by combining or equating equation 4 and 5. So by combining equation 4 and 5, now what is 4 and 5? Centrifugal force acting on the ball and the component of gravity force acting on the ball. We can write centrifugal force is M into R minus R omega square, and the component of gravity force is equal to mg cos theta. So this m and m gets cancelled. Now, just for the sake of your understanding, I will redraw this figure. Now, this angle is theta. Please remember, what is the maximum possible value of the component of gravity force? So, first of all, before I simplify, let me write it like this. Omega square is equal to cos theta upon r minus r. Say this is equation number 6. Now, for maximum operational speed we shall select a condition at which magnitude of gravity force is maximum. Now, why? Because we want more number of impacts. It is possible when the speed is more, and for the speed to be more, the magnitude of the centripetal force should also be higher, so that the magnitude of the set for the higher value of the centripetal force, that is mg cos theta, we shall select a condition at which the magnitude of the centripetal force is maximum, right? So that condition is, so centripetal force is maximum when theta is equal to 0. When theta is equal to 0, cos theta will be equal to 1, and maximum value of the cos theta is 1. So for the maximum value of cos theta equal to 1, theta should be equal to 0. That means this ball should be exactly over the top, like this. At this position, this ball should be, right? And therefore, so if you substitute theta is equal to 1, then we can rewrite this equation 6 as omega square is equal to 1 upon r minus r. Or this can be further written as omega is equal to under root of, sorry, this g is remaining, g cos theta. So this we can write g upon r minus r. Omega is equal to under root of g upon r minus r. So omega is equal to under root of g upon r minus r. This is equation number 7. But in our day-to-day life, we never refer to the angular velocity. Rather, we refer to the RPM, that is revolution per minute or revolution per second. And therefore, the relation between angular velocity and the speed is equal to omega is equal to 2 pi n. But we are referring to critical velocity or critical speed. Therefore, at theta is equal to 0, omega is equal to omega c, and this in turn can be written as nc. Therefore, substitute value of omega c in equation 7, and therefore we get 2 pi nc is equal to under root g upon r minus r, and therefore nc is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root g upon r minus r. So this is equation number 8. So this is the formula for calculating the critical speed of the ball mill. So if the diameter of the ball mill is known, from the diameter divided by 2, you can find out capital R. If diameter of the ball is known, diameter divided by 2, so you can write the radius of ball. Radius of ball mill, g is the gravitational acceleration, 9.81, this is pi, right? So from this you can find out what is nc. This, now please remember, the unit of this is 9.8 meter per second square, and therefore whatever the nc value you will be getting, that you will be getting it as a rps, and you have to multiply that rps by 60 to get RPM, because normally the speed is generally expressed in a RPM and not the RPS. So whatever the value you get, if you multiply it with 60, you will get the speed in RPM, right? Now once the critical speed is calculated, then as discussed earlier, n, that is equal to operational speed is equal to 50 to 70% of nc, 50 to 70% of nc. Many a times the reverse question is asked. The diameter of ball mill is given, the diameter of the ball may be given, and you may be asked to find out the operational speed. So for that, what you have to do is, first of all, you have to just substitute the value of R and G. You have to calculate NC, and if it is mentioned in the problem that operational speed of the ball mill is 35% of critical speed, calculate operational speed. So first calculate NC, then 0.35 into NC, that is 35%, that means 0.35 into NC will give you the operational speed. Or reverse case, they may give you operational speed, from that you may have to calculate critical speed, and if critical speed is known, if diameter of ball is known, you may calculate the radius of the ball mill or diameter of the ball mill. So anyway, if two parameters are given, then third one can be determined. It can be either NC, R or R, and once critical speed is known, then we know the relationship that operational speed N is equal to 50 to 70% of the NC. From this, you will also realize, or you must have recognized, that critical speed of the ball mill is the function of gravitational acceleration, radius or diameter of the ball mill and diameter of ball, but it is independent of mass of the grinding medium. It is independent of the mass of the grinding medium. That's it. And this is how we can derive an expression for finding out the critical speed of the ball mill. Thank you very much for cooperation, and just listening to what I was discussing.